Good morning and God bless you, church family, on this, the last day of June, Wednesday, June 30th. Oh man, that flew by. But anyway, here it is, another hot day, and then I hear it's supposed to break. That'd be good, because it was cooking yesterday, right? So tonight's our midweek refire service. Got a new message called Addicted to Likes, amen, and it's a two-part message. We'll do the first part today as we talk about King Saul. So that'll be 7 p.m. tonight. Please go ahead and share that when it comes up so that we can reach other people with the gospel of Jesus Christ. Amen. So I got the prayer request. I got the prayer maps. And I also have our little prayer chart. Today's the last day on this. We're praying for the Democratic Republic of Congo. Democratic Republic of Congo. So let's go ahead and pray today as we start this new day off. Let's take five to pray. Again, today is a reflection day, so no Bible reading on our 555 plan, but we're still reading the word. Amen. Father, we do bless you and we thank you again for this new day. It's hot, Lord, but it could be worse. And we know these things are temporary, Lord. We know that these things are going to pass. I read the other day, I believe it was in Pakistan, 127 degrees. All creation is going wacko. The creation is groaning for the revealing of the sons of man. And Lord, that's going to happen at the hapazo, the taking away of your church. And we look forward to that because we are looking up, because we are at warp speed, because scripture must be fulfilled. We do pray for our senior citizens, Lord, as they're this can hurt them more, Father, and we pray for strength, well-being on them, and also wisdom, Lord, wisdom. Lord, as we start our day off, we start it always with praise. From the rising of the sun to the time that it goes down, the name of the Lord shall be praised. And Father, with that, I thank you, Father, you said to pray for those that are in authority. So we lift up this United States of America, Father, we pray for our country as we're going through some crazy things, Lord. They're talking about heavy droughts this year, heat waves. They're talking about locusts invading our areas, lack of water in other areas, a high hurricane season. Whew, we are looking up, Lord. Our redemption draws nigh. Our minds can't handle it all, so we'll just settle in on thinking about you, and that soon, Lord, because we are on warp speed, we'll be coming home to Father's house, Lord, and that we look forward to. As we pray for the United States of America, Father, we pray for the those in the executive branch, legislative, judicial branch of our government, Lord. We pray from presidents to senators to House of Representatives to judges to governors to mayors, Lord. We bind up the ungodly, we loose the godly, Lord, and we just pray in Jesus' name, Lord, for them. We pray for the souls of the unsaved, Lord. Eternity is a long time to be wrong, Father. We pray for them. We pray also for kings, queens, prime ministers, and leaders of other nations, Lord. We do pray for Israel today, the peace of Jerusalem. But we lift up the nations in North America, South America, Asia, Europe, Africa, and the Pacific, Father. Father, we pray for the 8 billion people on planet Earth, Lord, that people would come to the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. We pray that scales be taken off their eyes and their hearts be open to the glorious message of the gospel. Father, we lift up tonight's service, Lord, and we pray that your word will go forth and that people will be born again, Lord. We lift up the prayer requests that I have in my hand and others that have been coming in this week, Lord. We pray for the needs of people, Lord. We pray for people, Father. And we just thank you again, Father, for hearts being open, Lord, to what you're doing, Lord. Father, I pray for your church. So many, Father, are not children of Issachar. They don't have a clue what's going on, Lord. And Father, Lord Jesus, you said, except the days be shortened, that even the very elect would be deceived, Lord. Father, for this great delusion and deception that's upon our earth that is bringing so many people in, we pray for people, for the scales to come off their eyes, their hearts to be open to the glorious light of the gospel. We pray for our young people, Lord. They just seem to be craziness that's going on out there. We pray for young people, Lord. We pray that they would come to the saving knowledge of Jesus. And we pray for those today that are in hospice care, those that are going to die today, those that are going to be in accidents today, whatever it might be. We pray that their hearts are ready, Lord. We don't want them entering into a Christless eternity, Lord. So we pray for them in Jesus' name. Now I lift up my brothers and sisters as we go forth on this day. As they pray for me, I pray for them, Lord. Lord, that their hearts will be open to your tug, Lord. For you said, as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. Thank you always for the tug on our hearts. I pray for healing upon them. We lay our hands upon ourselves, Lord, and we just pray healing from the top of our head to the soles of our feet, Lord. Lord, we know that this corruption must put on incorruption, this mortal must put on immortality. But till then, Lord, we keep our eyes on you, Lord, and we trust your word, Father. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. I thank you again for their faithfulness, Lord. And again, we just love you dearly. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God is good. Have an awesome day. I hope I see you tonight. Say hello in the comment section. God bless.